We're beginning tonight with continuing coverage of the power-stripped board at the Alisal Union School District.
The district has been under state control for more than a year now, and the board says it now wants to make its own decisions again in advance of the new school year. Action News reporter Brittany Nielsen is live in Salinas with more on the debate.
Well, Aaron, that's exactly right. And the state trustee is set to make a recommendation on the first week of September that will give the board some power back, but the state trustee will still have veto power over the board. Preparing to take back control of its board meetings. The Alisal Union School District Board will make the move from option B, in which the state trustee controls meetings, to option A.
In particular, in the last month or so, just through the discussions and the addressing of the topics, I can see that the board has come a ways and is ready to make that move to A.
The board has earned its anticipated promotion, attending 23 workshops and study sessions since January, in addition to standard board meetings.
It was a major commitment, and they said they wanted to do it and wanted to learn.
But many board members and district parents believe that much growth warrants complete self-governance, not part.
I do not see why we still need a state trustee. We've been on the right direction. We've gone over a lot of hurdles.
She should be gone. Terminate her term. It's over.
Dora Lopez has several nephews in the district and says funding should go to the kids, not to pay for unnecessary oversight.
We want most of our kids going to college, not going to somewhere else, to jail, to the streets. That's what we want. So with her here, again, even in another option, still, we're wasting our money.
I don't see, and I've been reading, and I don't see anything on option B, anything on the state that says you must recommend option A following option B. In essence, you can at this point recommend that this board is ready and full governance should be given to them.
It's viewed as a preparatory step of helping the board get ready for full governance. I'll lay out the criteria with the board for moving from option A to full governance, because you have to be looking forward.
Now, after this anticipated move from option B to option A, the state trustee hopes that the board will run its own meeting on September 21st. Erin.
All right, Brittany, thank you. So again, the trustee will retain so-called stay and rescind powers. She can veto a board decision if she doesn't believe it follows the guidelines of the corrective action plan set for the district.